Hey there, boys and girls. Prophet David Taylor here to share some prophetic wisdom with you. Today's topic, what's the difference between faith, hope, and love that the Bible talks about in 1 Corinthians chapter 13? That's mainly the love chapter, but at the very end it says, now abideth faith, hope, and charity, and the greatest of these is charity or love. Well, what's the difference between faith, hope, and love? Okay, well, they're all spiritual substances. They all live in the spiritual world, and they all live in your heart. Faith is a spiritual substance that God used to pull everything out of the invisible realm into the visible. It's the substance he used to make all the stuff that we see. And because we're made in his image, it's the same way we operate. When you conceive of something in your mind or your heart, that's your mind and your heart, your spirit, your deeper inner man, tapping into the spiritual realm and seeing what's there. And then the way you pull it from the invisible to the visible is by believing. You believe that what you're imagining can exist out here in the real world, and you believe you can do it. And that's putting some works behind your faith. So you use a spiritual substance of faith to pull things from the invisible to the visible, from the invisible realm where they live, out here where we can see it. That's the same way God made everything. And since we're made in his image, that's why we do it that way. That's how you built that business. That's how you wrote that book. That's how you build anything. You conceive of it first in your heart. And then you get some kind of blueprint or map in your mind. And then you put some works behind it. You're pulling it from the invisible to the visible. And how do we know that's true? Because when you get ideas, when you get song ideas, when you get book ideas, if you don't take them seriously, then later on you see somebody else giving birth to them. And you hear that song and you say, hey, wait a minute, I heard that before. Or you read that book and you say, hey, wait, that was my idea. Or you see that invention. Or you see that company and you said, hey, well, I thought about that. Okay, well, God was trying to get it to you. Your spirit tapped into it. It was in the invisible realm, but you didn't believe it. You didn't use any faith, so therefore you cannot pull it from the invisible realm out here into the physical realm where we are. That's faith. It's a substance. It's a spiritual substance. Okay? What is hope? Hope is the conceiving of the idea. So if it lives in your heart and lives in your mind and you want it to be real, you want it to happen, that's hope. Okay? Hope has a lot to do, a lot of desire is mixed in with hope, okay? But hope just brings it into the heart or into the mind, or hope just ignites your desire. It's not going to live out here. You're not going to have it in your life without faith, because faith is the thing you use to pull it. But hope is the thing that you use to add desire to your conceptions. You want it to happen. You can see it on the inside. Imagining the relationship you want, imagining the finances that you want, imagining the business that you want. When it gets mixed in with desire, that's hope. I want this to happen, okay? But it won't happen without faith. So then what is love? Love is a spiritual substance, and 1 Corinthians 13 goes through the characteristics of love, and it says that love is the greatest of them all. Well, what is love, and why is it the greatest of them all? Love is the thing that gives purpose and meaning and direction to whatever you birth through hope and faith. That's why if there's no love in it, it won't matter. If there's no kindness, if there's no forbearance, if there's no serving, if it doesn't serve mankind in some way, if there's no forgiveness involved, if there's keeping score, all the things that love is not, then those things that you pull into the world won't have any meaning. They'll be curses. They won't be blessings. Love is the thing that gives it meaning. Love is the thing that gives it righteousness. Love is the thing that gives it life. Love is its own reason and its own reward. And sometimes I liken it to like oil in a car. It's what, you know, greases the metal. It's what makes the machine work. Love is. Because if you don't have love, whatever that thing is that you hope for is not going to be a blessing. It's not going to be positive. And if that thing you use your faith to birth, I mean, you've seen it happen. You've seen it happen in marriages. You've seen it happen in churches. You've seen it happen in governments. You've even seen it happen in careers. That when people aren't walking in love anymore, if they ever were, or if people gave you an idea or a veneer of love, but it turns out that's not really who they are, that wasn't really their motive, then all of a sudden what happens? Their words are meaningless. Their career is meaningless. Their business is meaningless because it doesn't have any love. It doesn't have any component that serves mankind. If it's just self-serving, then it's not the fullest expression of love. If it's about keeping score, if it's about loving iniquity, loving that which is wrong, if it's unjust, that's not love. And we all know that anything, no matter what it is, but especially any type of organizational structure, if it's unjust, it doesn't matter. The successes don't even count. It's the reason why if you win, you know, Olympic medals and then they find out you're doping, you have to give them back. Why? Because you won them unjustly. Okay? You got to win them, as they used to say, fair and square. And that's what love is. It gives meaning, purpose, definition, foundation, you know, a reason. It greases the wheels. It's what makes what you pull out in here with your hope and your faith worth having. That's why love is the greatest, because you can conceive it with hope and birth it with faith, but if there's no love in it, it's not going to make any difference. All right? God bless you.